All right, the Hardys certainly no stranger to North Carolina. What did it mean for the Carolinas to have such a rooted history with Starrcade here?
I mean, I think it's really spectacular that Starrcade is back, especially it's been three decades, I think, is the number of people that had put on it. Starrcade is one of the reasons myself and my brother truly became fans. I mean, we grew up being huge fans of Ric Flair and of Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, of the Four Horsemen and the Rock and Roll Express. And we saw those guys in Starrcade events, and it was just, it was iconic, legendary performances. And now, fast forward to 2017, and for myself and my brother to be a part of a Starrcade event is a very cool thing. It's one of the things I think you almost, as a professional wrestler, you take a lot of things for granted doing, but this is like really cool. If you go back, you know, three decades ago to when we were just fans watching on television and pay-per-view, whatever it may be, and if we would know that, you know, so many years down the line, we'd be part of a Starrcade event, it'd be pretty mind-blowing at that time. So I think it's very cool, and I try to look at things in stride and not take things for granted.
Yeah, for me, just to introduce the Starrcade legends, you know, the Rock and Roll Express, I was like, wow. All I can think of is that Skywalkers, man. How insane that match was back then. And naturally, all I think of is, how can we bring that back? It's probably way too dangerous, but God bless those guys for being who they are.
And then why is the Starrcade so important to the Carolina area?
I think the Starrcade event itself is so important to the Carolina area just because it was born and bred here.
This
is
where place, right?
This is where it started. This is where it was born. You know, it was the birth child of Dusty Rhodes, you know, and for it just to come back here, I think North Carolina takes a lot of pride in its professional wrestling, sports entertainment, and Starrcade was just North Carolina's baby. And for Starrcade to come back here and happen again in 2017 in the most famous arena it was in, the Greensboro Coliseum, it's just truly special, and it's in so many ways just like magical, you know, just that would happen.
Oh, for sure, yeah, and I agree. It's kind of the birthplace of such a huge event, and just to be a part of it now, at 40 years of age, did this really happen?
And
I guess it did.
And just to like put a bow tie on this, just like it's North Carolina's baby, and you always want to see your firstborn, you know, especially 30 years down the road. So to get to see it again is really neat and really special.
So can you guys kind of try to explain what you guys were doing in the ring there with New Day?
Yeah, I got the rhythm down from the horn, and I saw Matt go off, and then I said, man, maybe I could go off, but I took my sling off trying to get a pop, you know, and oh God, he's going to do something, but then again, I wanted to play it safe, and I tried to do that button movement it was probably worse than yours, actually.
I'm a big fan of New Day and their antics, because they're very over the top, they're very cartoony-ish in many ways, very kid-friendly, very fun. So they pulled that on us. We had no idea that was happening. So obviously when they come to the ring and they're like, hey, we want you to dance and shake your booty, you know, invest in some bootios. And when they came out and they started it, I was like, okay, well, how can I make this as over the top as possible? And that's what I was attempting to do when I was out there doing this. I was trying to make it as over the top as possible.
And finally, switching gears a little bit, Jeff, everyone's wondering how the rehab is going. How is the rehab going?
So far, so good. My physical therapist says it's moving great. You know, it don't feel great. Naturally, it hurts, and I can only do so much. But I'm on the right track. So hopefully after another month, I'll actually be able to lift a little weight and start building up my chest and my arms again. And then hopefully by April, I'll be good to go and actually get back in the ring and do what Jeff Hardy loves to do.
Excited for that.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.